Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be discussing frequently asked questions and myths surrounding motor oil. Now rather than me blabbering and trying to convince you of what is true, I'm going to be asking Shanna Simmons, who is a research engineer for Shell, who has access to the information and research needed to answer these questions, and hopefully she can put some of these myths to rest. So my first question is, I put 5W30 in one of my cars. What does that combination of letters and numbers mean?
Let's discuss what a multigrade viscosity really means. So the 5 is the viscosity grade when it's cold. So remember, the W stands for winter. The 30 is the viscosity grade at the engine's operating temperature. Engines operate around 212 degrees Fahrenheit.
Okay, so why should I change my oil?
As an engine burns fuel, it deteriorates the motor oil. Changing your oil helps to remove harmful contaminants and it replenishes the additives that have been depleted.
So what is the typical composition of motor oil?
So this chart shows the typical composition of motor oil. So depending on the formulation, the motor oil will be about 75 to 90% base oil. The other 10 to 25% will be additives. So the base oil determines the fundamental properties of the motor oil, and the additives help to enhance the base oil, help to protect the base oil, and help to protect the mechanical equipment.
Okay, now you mentioned oil additives. Are aftermarket oil additives something I should be using?
No. Pennzoil branded products already contain carefully balanced additives for optimal performance.
And I'm sure that same logic can be applied to many of the brands of oil out there. Now, a lot of people debate about conventional and synthetic oil. And before we get into that, basically what's the difference between these two terms?
So the base oil can either be conventional or synthetic. If the base oil is conventional, it means it's only been refined from crude oil. If it's synthetic, it means it's gone through an additional chemically engineered process to give it better properties for use in a motor oil.
Okay, so is synthetic oil compatible with conventional oil, and can the two be mixed?
Yes. Motor oil labeled a synthetic blend already contains both synthetic and conventional base oil in the formulation. We also carefully test our motor oils with other oils to ensure compatibility.
A lot of people debate on whether or not you can use synthetic oil to break in an engine. Can you?
Yes. In fact, a majority of vehicles manufactured today are factory filled with synthetic oil, and many race teams also use synthetic oil to break in their engines.
Now, sludge is a term that's often brought up when talking about engines and oil. What is sludge and what causes it?
So every time your engine is running, byproducts from combustion build up and contaminate the motor oil. If contaminants build up inside your engine, they can settle out and form sludge. Using low quality motor oil, neglecting to change your oil, and maintenance issues can all lead to sludge forming inside your engine.
Now, I often get the question, can I use this certain viscosity grade even though the manufacturer suggests another viscosity grade? Why should I use the viscosity grade that the manufacturer recommends?
Your engine was designed with a specific viscosity grade in order to lubricate mechanical parts properly. If you use an oil that is too thin, you may run into wear issues. If the oil is too thick, engine efficiency may decrease. Always follow your vehicle's owner's manual to determine the correct SAE viscosity grade to use inside your engine.
So a huge thank you to Shanna for helping answer some of these questions. And as always, if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Thanks for watching.